Hi, I'm Hayley Victoria and welcome back to my Crime and Policing channel. Today we're going to be looking at sexual harassment. Obviously a massive subject at the moment, and it has always been, just so you know. It's not something that people just started doing. It's just that now we're actually respecting each other a lot more, which is great. Now, it's a common misconception that sexual harassment only happens male to female. It happens from all genders to each other, and it needs to stop. It really is not good. I know on this channel we've been looking at forensic science, but we need to start, you know, weaving in the law now as well. And that's what we're going to do. It's important that everybody feels safe and secure and happy. And nobody wants to go home with the keys in the pocket ready in case somebody attacks them. You know what I mean? You've probably all done it. So, we'll talk about offensive weapons as well soon. The Equalities Act in 2010 said sexual harassment is if someone's behaviour is either intended to be or has the effect of making someone feel like their dignity is being violated, or creating an intimidating, hostile, degrading, humiliating or offensive environment. If someone's doing that, they are sexually harassing somebody. That's sexual harassment of the Equalities Act 2010. Now then, what does that look like in real life? So it's a lot of legal words and terms and stuff there. This could be sexualized jokes or comments, bants. It's not banter, it's abuse, coined under different terms, so don't do it. Physical behavior, so you're in someone's personal space, you're being a bit leche and you're touching somebody up, that's sexual harassment. And it could also be sexual assault, which I'll talk about in a minute too, which is when you start looking at your criminal offenses as well. And you don't want those on your record. Displaying pictures, photos or drawings of a sexual nature. So if you work in a workshop, some workshop somewhere, a garage, something like that, and you've got some calendars up there or something with sexualized images on that might cause somebody to feel that way, that's sexual harassment. Sending messages with sexualized content, so that could be on any forum. Could be social media, could be email, could be text messages. You're sending those messages at sexual harassment. Okay? So don't do it. It's gross. And sexual posts and comments on social media too is sexual harassment. There's a lot of it. Basically, if something you are doing or how you are acting could make somebody feel like their dignity is being violated, or it could offend them, intimidate them, make them feel that the area is hostile and degrading and humiliating, that's sexual harassment. You wouldn't want it to happen to you, your relatives, or anybody you care about. So if you see it happening, report it and do not be an accomplice to it. Just, yeah, no means no. And just have respect for each other because, you know, it's gross. When we look at sexual harassment and stuff then, it's natural that we move on to sexual assault and other offences such as Section 7 of the Children's Act in 1978. We're starting to look at things about distribution of imagery of children. Children under this act are anybody who is under 18. So if you're one of my students and you are aged under 18, considering taking pictures of yourself, indecent pictures, intimate pictures of yourself, to send them to somebody, then don't, because you are creating and distributing child pornography. And you're also in possession of it because it's on your device, and deleting it's an offence too, so don't do that. If you receive these images, you are in possession of child pornography. Any of these things could be on your record for a long, long time. You don't want that at your young age before you started your careers. And if you are encouraging somebody under 18 to send you those images, guess what? You are also involved in the creation of child pornography. So do not do it. And people often mistakenly think that things like Snapchat can't be traced. Yeah, that's not true. So, what's important to mention is that if you receive an image that you don't want, and you are, that person's under 18 or you are under 18, you report it to somebody who you feel safe to report it to. Try not to show it to them, so you know, them viewing it, because then they're looking at child porn. But what you need to do is tell somebody you trust, and they can pass it on to the right authorities to deal with it. Okay? And if anybody makes you feel, or tries to make you feel like you should be sharing intimate pictures, they don't care about you. They should be sending you flowers, not rude pictures. Okay, that's that bit covered. What we're gonna look at as well is sexual assault. So, if you touch somebody with any part of your body or with anything else in a sexualized way, they don't consent to, or you don't reasonably think they consent to it, that's sexual assault. So you touch somebody with either any part of you or with anything else in a sexualized way without their consent or reasonable belief that they do consent, that's assault. It's a very serious offense. So don't do that either. Even if it's just a joke or bants, don't do it. I want you all to stay safe, look after each other, and if you see something's wrong, report it, because if you see something bad, you don't do anything about it, you're just as bad as the person who's done it. Thank you.